Following the US's restriction of top-tech semiconductor chip materials to China, the Dutch multinational corporation Advanced Semiconductor Materials Lithography still sits pretty at the top of things. Founded in 1984 in the Netherlands, the Dutch company took a significant risk by taking on uncharted territories in the research and development of EUVs, an expedition which their competitors thought of as being futile. It took exactly 15 years for the company to see the light at the end of the tunnel, releasing its first major products with a market cap of about $200 billion in 2022 and a monopoly to maintain. Your guess is as good as mine on who is smiling now. While there have been a lot of positives to take from the major successes in a decade and a half, ASML was hit by restrictions from its home country and the United States on the exportation of its semiconductors to China. This resulted in a drop in its major market space as China was responsible for 16% of its sales. But so far, so good, the tech giant looks unfazed by the big disruption in its industry, and as for China, they are looking to scout for other alternatives to rival ASML in the US while searching for backup planes at home. So then, let us take a look at four green flags for ASML in the future, as it seems that China is way too hell. ASML held an investor day on November 11th, raising guidance for 2025, and initiated its guidance for 2030, expecting to double the production of top-tier chip-making machines by 2025, even as it doesn't expect significant headwinds in China. ASML's big guidance boost for 2025 and beyond. During an ASML's investor day in September, the company forecasted sales of 24 billion to 30 billion euros in 2025, with a gross margin ranging from 54% to 56%. Its estimates are based on its low and high scenarios for global wafer demand and the semiconductor industry. However, in November 2022, ASML revised its sales projection for 2025 to 30 billion to 40 billion euros while maintaining its gross margin guidance of 54% to 56%. It also forecasts annual sales of 44 to 60 billion euros by 2030, with a gross margin ranging from 56% to 60%. According to the midpoint of that prediction, ASML's yearly sales might rise at a compound annual growth rate of 12% from 2021 to 2030. Its gross margin would also rise considerably from 52.7% in 2021, which is hardly surprising considering its unequaled pricing power in the European Union. Despite the fact that ASML produced 15% of its system sales in China last year, it only offers lower-end deep ultraviolet systems there. The Dutch government previously barred the company from selling its EUV systems to China amid escalating concerns about Chinese chipmakers imitating and producing more advanced chips. The Biden administration took a ban on China, prohibiting all American companies from exporting advanced semiconductors, equipment, and services to China. ASML CEO Peter Wenning stated in October 2022 that all of the bans would have a minimal impact on system sales in 2023 because the company only sold DUV systems in China. Wenning maintained that view during ASML's Investor Day presentation, stating that even if Chinese chipmakers were unable to grow capacity beyond current levels, the constraints would produce a temporary hiccup but would not significantly affect its 2030 projection. He stated that even if new production facilities are not created in China, they will be needed abroad to meet the market's increasing need for new chips. ASML delivered 42 EUV systems, which cost $150 million to $200 million each and take numerous aircraft to transport, as part of an increase of its yearly capacity in 2021. It is nonetheless shipping and installing these systems as quickly as it can, and it is even introducing fast shipments, which bypass part of the testing process and delay billings for select clients, to get them out the door faster. As a result, even as the semiconductor industry cools, demand for ASML's EUV systems continue to overwhelm supply. This is because TSMC, Samsung, and Intel must continue to invest in smaller and denser circuits in order to stay ahead of the technology curve. As a result, ASML intends to boost its annual capacity to 90 EUV and 600 DUV, up from 267 units in 2021, by 2025 to 2026. It also plans to begin shipments of next-generation high-end EUV systems in 2023, allowing its clients to generate even more tiny chips and increase its yearly manufacturing capacity to 20 systems by 2027 to 2028. On top of that bright prediction, ASML announced a fresh share repurchase program worth up to 12 billion euros, which will run through the end of 2025. This amounts to around 5% of ASML's current market capitalization and would continue the company's regular buybacks over the last decade. At 32 times next year's profits, ASML's stock isn't cheap. However, its monopoly on a critical chip-making technique justifies the premium, and its recent investor day implies it still has lots of potential as it expands capacity and releases new systems. As a result, ASML remains a simple company to purchase and keep for long-term investors. While these are positives to take from the tech giant, how about China? How do the restrictions from the United States affect them? In April 2021, a Semiconductor Industry Association and Boston Consulting Group report warned that export rules have encouraged China to develop its own alternative chip machinery manufacturers. Shanghai Microelectronics Equipment is one company positioned as Beijing's alternative to ASML.
In 6 months, this led to a ban on China from receiving high-class semiconductor materials from the USA, already causing concern for ASML. CEO Peter Wenink, in an interview, said, "They'll be able to do it all themselves in 15 years, and their market will be gone."
While that sheds some light on the Chinese tech industrial journey to replicating or surpassing the semiconductor technology from the Western world, what issues do they face? The ban will slow China's chip technology progress, however, it won't stop it. The export restriction will also harm China's efforts to establish self-sufficiency in chip manufacturing, which Russia has also mentioned as a goal. The etching of exact patterns on silicon wafers is a skill that China has yet to perfect and for which it is heavily reliant on international equipment. The restrictions effectively prevent China from acquiring that method until they are able to create a solution to this process themselves. The United States intends to keep China out of the new growing technology sector for a long period. For example, in electric vehicles, the United States also aims to dominate, such as in electric automobiles. To put it in context, there are around 1 billion gasoline-powered automobiles worldwide. This is predicted to fall by half by 2030, implying a potential growth market of 500 million EVs between now and the end of the decade. Washington expects its manufacturers to grab the lion's share of it, at least in the regions over which it has political power. China's economy has been among the world's fastest growing, with real annual GDP growth averaging 9.5% through 2018, a rate described by the World Bank as the fastest continuous expansion by a major economy in history. Through a number of high-profile initiatives, such as Made in China 2025, a plan announced in 2015 to upgrade and modernize China's manufacturing in 10 key sectors with extensive government assistance in order to make China a major global player in these sectors, the Chinese government has prioritized innovation in its economic planning. However, such steps have heightened fears that China plans to employ industrial policies to reduce the country's reliance on foreign technology, including the exclusion of foreign enterprises in China, and eventually dominate global markets. The United States considered this as a danger to its economic interests, raising taxes by 25% on $250 billion in Chinese imports, while China raised taxes, varying from 5% to 25%, on $110 billion in U.S. imports. Such policies significantly reduced bilateral trade in 2019. Getting this blow from a top player on its productivity, manufacturing, and innovation, which are top priorities responsible for its economic growth, seems to happen to China's technological growth a little. The US is potentially locking China out of the future market, but the question is, how would China respond to these sanctions in the world of tech and in the industrial market? As they seem to be far gone already. We're sure you enjoyed this video. So make sure you like and comment on this video. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications, so you don't miss our other videos.